Dear Lord, I know I don't talk with you enough. Here anymore, it's just because he's late. I always knew his days would be long and tough, but I didn't know how hard it'd be to wait. It's 2 hours past dark, 4 past quitting time. He should have been home by now. Where's he at? Storm's coming on, I can hear my wind chimes. About then, the first raindrop falls with a splat. He mentioned he was checking heifers today, up in the high pasture, the one past the creek. He's going to trot out, thought he'd take the gray. That raunchy one, you know, with the mean streak. I know I shouldn't worry, but yet I do. He's a big boy, he can take care of himself. His absence continues to make my mind stew. Could he be hiding beneath the rocky shelf? Maybe that no-good colt tipped over on him. Maybe those heifers are scattered all around from hell to breakfast out on that shell rock rim. And maybe he's lying wounded on the ground. At the door, I strain to hear his jingle bobs, regardless of the brewing storm just outside. This is the downfall of these cowboying jobs, peering into the dark, looking for his stride. Lord, please quiet my mind and ease this girl's heart. For the sake of my sanity, send him home. As his wife, I've always tried to do my part. I promised from his side I would not roam. The dog perks his ears and heads towards the front door. I can hear it too, his cinch bell ringing. And comes the end of my eternal war this time. But the battle wounds are still stinging.